The words of the Holy One, the true One, who has the key of David, who opens and no one will shut, who shuts and no one opens. Behold, I know your works. Behold, I have set before you an open door, which no one is able to shut. I know that you have little power, and yet you have kept my word, and you have not denied my name. Behold, I will make those of the synagogue of Satan say that they are Jews and are not, but lie. Behold, I will make them come and bow down before your feet, and they will learn that I have loved you. Because you've kept my word about patient endurance, I will keep you from the hour of trial that is coming on the whole world. Try those who dwell on the earth. I am coming soon. Hold fast to what you have, so that no one may seize your crown. To the one that conquers, I will make him a pillar in the temple of my God. Never shall he go out of it. I will write on him the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, the new Jerusalem, which comes down from my God out of heaven, and my own new name. He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. This letter written to the Church of Philadelphia. We believe that we are in those times. Though they may try to close the door, Jesus says they will not be able to. You hold fast. You endure. You be faithful. It's not your size, but your strength that the Lord honors, and he will protect his church. Let's stand as we bow in worship. Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning. Word is truth and it feeds our soul. Father, this morning we pray that you would protect your children. Protect those, Father, who have chosen to stand and worship you in these times, even from California to New York. Your church worships you. Heavenly Father, I pray that you would give your children the humility and the grace to withstand the persecution that comes. As you have promised to give us, Father, your strength. Father, we pray for our friends and neighbors that do not know you as their Savior. Lord, use us in these times that we would be a light and a salt, and that we would speak with courage and love and grace about Jesus, that they would accept you in their life. Father, we pray for this city. We pray for the state. Father, we pray for this country. Lord, we pray for our governor and our president and those that are making the laws in this state house and the state house in Washington. Oh, Lord, have mercy on them. You who turn the hearts of kings as rivers in the palm of your hand, have mercy on our country. Forgive us our sin for the murder and the hatred pride and the sin and the lust. Have mercy and forgive us. Forgive your church for being, Father, inward looking too much and not outward serving. Oh Lord, if the judgment begins in your house, have mercy and forgive us. Let us judge ourselves. And Lord, Father, then I pray that you would pour out mercy and revival in this land. Oh, Lord, bring the unity in the Word, the unity under God once again. Father, let this revival begin in our hearts and in this place. Accept our worship today. Keep our minds on you. Keep our thoughts in your Word. And teach each one of us directly from your Word. Uplift our spirits in song, bow our hearts in prayer. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I need my music. Anyway, good to have all of you here with us this morning. I trust that all of us are here to praise our Lord this morning, to lift Him up. If you're here for your own purposes, deal with it. We're here for God's purposes this morning. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. All right. Let's begin this morning by singing, "Oh, how I love Jesus." He's the one that we're here for.
There is a name I love to hear. I love
to sing its word. It sounds like music in my ear. The sweetest name on earth. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh,
worthy of all our praise.
the idea of how it goes. Okay? So let's go ahead and try that. And let's have you stand up.
There is no rock, there is no God like our God. No other name
worthy of all our praise. The rock of salvation.
Love being there for